Serge was a little frustrated because he thought he was going to be able to go out and get me whatever I craved and whatever I wanted. And I had the problem of I didn't want anything or crave anything until I smelled it. And I had to smell my food before I would eat it. I could cook a whole meal. And if it didn't smell right when I was done with it, you know, just because I put the wrong spice in there or something, then I couldn't eat it.
Well, what about this place here? Let's check out the menu.
No.
And we would go out on walks. Sometimes just around in the square and...
No, that's not gonna work.
She would have to smell it first. Just see what caught her fancy at that time.
Yeah.
As soon as it did, then that's where we would go.
And that lasted throughout my entire pregnancy.
How was it?
Garlicky, yum.
Baby likes it.
Yeah, I'm pretty hungry.
I'm still like that. I still really want to smell my food. And if I smell something and I'm just like, oh, I have to have that. I have to have it now.
Yeah. It's no surprise that Melinda might be especially hungry. The fetus she's carrying has only one source for all the raw materials it needs to grow into a baby. Melinda's blood, which is systematically raided with the help of the placenta. The placenta began to form as soon as the blastocyst burrowed into the mother's uterus. And in the early weeks, it dwarfed the embryo. The underside of the placenta is covered with thousands of tiny projections called villi, which lie in pools of the mother's blood. Without ever mixing the blood of mother and child, the villi grab oxygen and nutrients. The enriched blood flows about a foot and a half through the umbilical cord back to the fetus, whose heart beats about twice as fast as an adult's. The heart is one of the few organs that actually work during the earliest weeks of development. But with other organs, function comes later. With the eye, although the retina and lens are well formed by the ninth week, the fetus doesn't respond to light until the fifth or sixth month. And the same for the ear. The outer ear quickly takes shape, but the fetus can't hear yet. Sound conduction relies on the tiny bones of the inner ear, and most of the bones in the fetus start out as cartilage. By the fourth month, hard bone can be seen forming in the hand and the leg. Finally, after 5 months, the process is complete in the inner ear. And then the fetus begins to hear sound.
I would sing songs right on her belly, just so that it could hear my voice and get to know my voice. But there was...
And what else? It'd make whale noises?
Yes. One of the first times I did that, the baby seemed to move its hand across her belly and kind of touch my lips, or at least I like to think it was a hand saying hello or something.
And I even play music. You know, I wanted to see what would happen to what different kinds of music. And, you know, Mozart, was mellow, kind of made some movements. And then I put salsa music in, and it's just started kicking, almost in rhythm. So it was great.
Got a particular beat that it likes.
Yeah.
There's three of us dancing. Is the baby moving?
Inside Melinda's belly, a remarkable transformation has taken place, starting with the moment egg and sperm met.